Hello friends, welcome to Easy Learning Economics. I am Dr. Kaval. Today we shall learn International Dependence Revolution. In this lecture, we shall discuss the new classical dependence model, false paradigm model, and dualistic development thesis. In the classical theories of growth, we learned in detail the Rostow's five stages of growth, the Harrod-Domar growth model. Now we are going to learn about international dependency theory, that is the part of the classical theories of growth. So if you want to learn in detail the classical theories of growth, what are the Rostow's five stages of growth, Harrod-Domar growth model, and Arthur Lavis theory of growth, you can watch my videos. The links are given in the description box. The international dependence approach is with three major streams of thought: the new classical dependence model, false paradigm model, and the dualistic development thesis. The new classical dependence model. The new classical dependence model analyzes the dynamics of underdevelopment. What causes underdevelopment? It also examines the internal and external forces and structures. This model describes the dependence and dominant relationship among the rich and poor economies. The rich countries are the core nations or high income countries exploits and misuse the poor countries' resources and labor for their own benefits. As a result, the rich become richest and poor become the poorer. Poor countries or low income countries' functions are surrounded through the landlords, elite class, certain political groups who directly and indirectly act and serve the policies of foreigners, IMF and World Bank, and creating the cycle of dependency that contributes towards inequality and poor economic growth at the global level. In the second part of the international dependence revolution, the false paradigm model, this model explains the intentions of the rich economies. Although developed countries want to help the developing countries, but their policies for developing nations are inappropriate and don't suit the developing countries from all aspects at social, cultural, and institutional levels. As a result, they remain underdeveloped. Dualistic development thesis, this is the one of the concept of the international dependence revolution. This thought explains the coexistence of the superior and inferior elements like extreme poverty and affluence. Modern and traditional economic sector, growth and stagnation, education and illiteracy, out of which one is desirable but other not, they are causing the increasing divergence and inequality among rich and poor nations. The superior element does little or nothing to pull up the inferior, but serve to push it down, that causes underdevelopment. I hope that you have understand the international dependence revolution model. If you have any queries or comments, let me know in the comment section. Thanks for watching.